just needed to see ya. See ya. See ya. See ya. See ya.
The first bookstore. I feel so awkward right now because we're in public, but we're in Toronto. Show you at the end, but now we're walking to the last bookstore. We're almost there. Hopefully the clips have been interesting. I have no idea, honestly. I'm just kind of filming everything, but yeah, and then we're gonna go to the mall.
Yes,
then we're gonna go to the mall. Unfortunately, neither does she. Ivy actually haven't bought anything, but I bought some stuff, as you already saw, but nothing from the last store. But now we are walking back to the Eaton Center. We'll probably hop on a subway at some point because it's a little far away, and we're gonna go to Indigo because I need to buy the Silent Patient, and then we'll have dinner. Woop, woop, woop. already available. Nice. I didn't know that this was sci-fi. Oh, it's so pretty. Okay, it won't focus, but look at how big this is. And there's marshmallows. I can't see it, but look. That is so crazy. Yum. Okay, I just got home. I am so exhausted. But I thought I would show what I got. So really quickly, from the very first bookstore, I got Gone with the Wind by Margaret Mitchell. And I freaked out when I saw this because, if you don't know, basically my favorite book ever is The Outsiders by S.E. Hinton. And in this book, they read Gone with the Wind. So when I saw it, I was like, okay, well, I kind of need to get it because it's in my favorite book slash movie, and I've always been really curious about it. So it was only $6, so I decided to get it. It is a huge book, but I am really happy that I own this now. And then from the second thrift store bookstore, I got Eleanor Oliphant. Oliphant is Completely Fine. I've been wanting to read this for a really long time. And it's the type of book that I feel like I'll really like, and I might want to read it more than once. So it was only $9. Yeah, $9. So I decided to get it. It has this cover and not the other cover with like a girl, like her, I guess, on it. But I don't know, this is cute. And again, it was $9 and I've been wanting to read it for a while. It does have like these pages where it's like kind of rough. I don't know if you know what I mean or if you can tell, but I don't know. I am excited about this book, so yeah. And if you don't know, it's about a girl that's just like not really good at like social skills, and she meets a guy from her office, and it says that they save an elderly man together, and then the three of them kind of just help each other in life. I don't know, it sounds really nice. Ivy didn't like this book very much, but I think I will. So, and the guy cashing me out, the man at the bookstore, told me that it's a really good book, so I'm excited. The second book I got from that second store is called The Artist of the Missing by Paul Lafarge. And then it has illustrations by Steph Alcorn. Look at how beautiful the cover is, and like the back too. And it also has those like ragged pages, so that's annoying. But it's a mystery about a young artist that meets a woman, and the woman disappears, and he needs to like go find her. So it's kind of like a mystery type book. And it has really nice pictures, like illustrations, all throughout the novel. Like, it's really cool. So I mostly got it just because this is beautiful and it has illustrations throughout, but it also sounds like a book I'll actually enjoy. This one was also $9. I've never heard of it before, but I don't know, I just had to get it. And finally, as you saw, I ended up going to an actual bookstore and buying The Silent Patient by Alex Michaelides. I'm not sure, but I'm part of a Discord book group, and this is the book of the month for October, since it's like a thriller. I've been wanting to read this for a couple months too, and I think I'm really gonna love it. For those of you that don't know, it's about a woman who kills her husband and then goes mute. She refuses to ever talk again, so they send her to a mental hospital. And there's one criminal psychotherapist named Theo Faber who is really captivated by her story, and he really wants to like get into her head and try to like make her talk. And apparently there's like a huge twist at the end. I don't know, but I love psychological thrillers. I studied psychology in university, if you didn't know, so I feel like this is like right up my alley. So I'm really excited, and I hope I love it so that I can read it like 100 times. But that's it for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed. I really had fun. It was so fun going book shopping in various different stores around Toronto, and I just had a lot of fun hanging out with my friend and going to places I had never really gone to before. So yeah, make sure you like this video if you enjoyed, subscribe down below, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!